and to what the main thing is, if you learn something, my way of teaching, as long back as I can remember, has always been to teach principles. So study the principles. You know, don't put a great deal of concentration into the mechanics or the technique. Get the principles correct and the techniques will come. And if you practice the principles forever, they're constant, and then all different techniques will come from that. What I want to show you just now is what Riai means. Our club's called Makototai Aikido Riai. Makoto means purely. No politics, no personalities, no egos, no hardly any reason for doing Aikido. The reason is Aikido itself, just purely. That's all we're here for. Riai means complete, or to be complete, you must have an understanding of the sword and the stick. Take it a little further, you must have an understanding of some other martial arts as well. But I don't know when. Someday in the future we'll show you Aikido against Wing Chun or against Karate. It doesn't change much at all. The principles are constant, but there are slight adaptations to the techniques. But we'll do that for another one. But Riai, for instance, the Kurijo, just number one. He asked me, you know, to do the one, two, three, now, for the sword, I could make it the same. It would make no difference. If I don't have a draw and cross, I can effectively make the techniques. If I have a draw and he tries to catch it, then I can throw. So I've got a joke, I don't have a joke, he has a joke. It doesn't matter. That would be considered Aikido Riai. Complete. In that situations change. What your Aikido doesn't. That means you're getting it.